Boom! Just hit that dab, ladies and gentlemen. That was my first time doing that, definitely, today. Hi, I'm Jelxies. I'm gonna be a little bit more happy this time. Fuck you. Hi, I'm Jelxies from the Let's Level podcast, also the creator of the podcast that'll get straight bitches. Okay, I am here with my friend, Alejandro, also known as the Twisted Phantom.
What's going on, people?
And we are joined, we're going to do this joke two times in a row today, we are joined with the legendary yodeling kid from Walmart. Can we please get him out here? Alejandro, start clapping. I mean, good job. Like, I've never met another kid that can yodel inside of a Walmart and get appraisal. First time I tried doing it, man went up to me and touched my ass, but that's a different story.
Hi.
Okay, welcome everyone to the Let's Level podcast. Today, we are a show talking about video games, so you don't have to. No, we're not pulling a fucking... I feel like I should have music on this, but I feel like I get copyright claimed.
You can use my playlist.
Show me your playlist, Daddy.
Actually, it has copyright material.
Okay, whatever. I really don't care about copyright.
Actually, I don't feel comfortable with my playlist being on here.
Why?
I mean, you can look at it, but don't judge me. Actually, no, I don't want it.
Dude, I listen to a whole bunch of shit. If it has anime or not, I really
care. It's Amazon Music. You can't get to it.
I have Amazon Prime.
Crap.
I also have Amazon Prime.
No, fuck it. We're doing a Snail House playlist. Oh, no, we're doing Avicii for because Avicii died.
Oh, yeah, Avicii died. Oh, breaking news.
Breaking news 2 days, like 5 days later, Avicii died.
Wait, who?
Avicii. He was a giant music creator.
You know, he's the guy that went feeling away through the darkness.
And then he also did Avicii Levels. You probably know like 60 of his songs, but you don't know who he is.
Pretty much.
That's literally what I'm trying to tell you. You can also, can you guys hear yourself through the podcast now? Is that okay?
Probably.
Damn. Rip Avicii, 1989 to 2018. Damn, he went through the 90s just to get to here. Damn, that sucks. All right, we're putting him on the background. Avicii. I know the Avicii shit's probably claimed by some corporate fucking... We're not listening to Wake Me Up. I don't care. I like his shit, and I want to remember him in this podcast forever.
Wake me up inside.
All right. Let's talk about this podcast. All right. What is up first up on the agenda, boys? We are talking about VR and how it's slowly being able to do meme review. Okay. So, Microsoft released these headsets called the Virtual... Listen to this mindfuckery. Dell Visor Virtual Reality Headset. But what they're actually called are Windows Mixed Reality Headsets.
The mixed reality headset.
They're not mixed reality. They're just VR. They call them mixed reality because the HoloLens, they already claimed, uses VR. So, they fucked it up. But
even though the HoloLens was like a shit product that didn't work.
HoloLens is still being out. It's not fully out yet, but I hopefully think it's going to do well.
Yeah.
But I have good news. Basically, for $245, like you see on screen right now, collate that slide, whatever, we're not doing that slide. oh man, that resets my thing every time whatever. So basically, what's happening, is that VR is now at a state where it's actually kind of cheap to even play with controllers and like full room tracking, cause these headsets come with trackers inside the headset that allow you to move the controllers anywhere in front of you and also kind of tracks behind you, but that's a different story, not as much. And basically, it allows you to have full room tracking without those little boxes, and for like a half of the price, for $250. I think that's something new, you know, that's great, because I want to do VR really badly. Next paycheck, don't let me down.
And if that's not enough, there's more. Now, you can touch butts in virtual reality. Never been able to do before.
With the virtual gloves.
Now with the virtual gloves, you can touch some ass. No.
You can definitely be Ready Player One.
You can have that. You know that sex scene that they wanted to put in Ready Player One?
VR,
now you can live that.
Or you mean VR chat in the movie?
Yo, has anybody here seen Player One besides me?
I've seen Player One. You know, interesting about Player One is that it... Oh, sorry, Detective Bird, were you saying something?
No, he wasn't.
Okay, you're not important. No, I'm kidding. No, I love you. Okay, What was interesting about Ready Player One is that the fact that if it didn't feel like a movie, it felt like a pilot to what a game is going to be coming out in like 2 years.
Exactly. That's one of my things. And when I read the book was about kind of like how games are ruining us, just by the by.
I mean, they did explain that in the beginning, but it was more just like it was an escape.
No, but the ending was changed for the movie. And one of the other things is like the mother wasn't as mean as she was in the movie, or the stepmother, whatever the fuck it was.
Yeah.
The mother,
I mean, I never read the book,
was
so.
Actually just whoring herself out in line so they can get more money. Well, not the mother, the stepmother. And the only thing she got mad at him in the book about was like that fight happened in the book, but it wasn't the same way.
Jokes, I think someone asked you a question.
Somebody asked me a question. Where?
On your stream watch time.
Stream? Did you send me a question?
I don't see any questions.
It's on my Streamlabs. Can I touch your ass from Mr. Bird? Oh no, let's put this up on the stream, ladies and gentlemen. Right there. It's not even spelled correctly. Can I touch your ass? The answer is yes.
Sweet, let's get on VR.
Okay, so. Basically, besides me nerding about the book and shit, Ready Player One was a good movie? I guess you can say that.
It was decent.
It was just like a whole bunch of homages. The book was kind of bad in my opinion. I thought the book was originally good, and then I just started like reading more and more, and I'm like, this is just turning into, this guy is really fucking creepy. Yeah, so he was just really fucking creepy in the book, and they toned down his creepiness for the movie.
Wait, whose creepiness?
The main character's creepiness.
Let me get some examples.
Nope, don't get examples.
Oh, hey, I'm a...
Alright, so we're moving on from VR. Basically, what we're trying to say, VR sheep, you should do it. If you have a good computer for it.
VR is the future of gaming.
Next up, we have Xbox One game news, because I'm an Xbox type guy. I know some people aren't. Basically, what's happening in this article from Express UK, basically what's happening is that they found job listing for 4K graphics development at 60 FPS for Halo 6. So, we're getting a new Halo. It's gonna be shit. It's from 343. I really don't care. And also, another job advertisement for, Crackdown 3 for the same exact thing. So, Crackdown 3! I don't think that's gonna be bad. You guys got anything to say about this one?
No, but Roblox getting voice chat? Perhaps?
What? No. Is it actually?
Yes, I actually saw a thing that's like on the Roblox site saying that they're hiring people to work on voice chat. I'm not joking.
Do you know what's gonna happen? I'm gonna tell you exactly what's gonna happen. Alright. Alright. What's gonna happen is that you're gonna go onto a server, right? I love how my thing saying Jared has started podcasting is starting now. What's gonna happen is that you're gonna go, hey, Kay, what on the mic, and then there's gonna shut the fuck up! Shut the fuck up, you piece of shit! Like from some like 72-year-old. Hey kids, do you wanna play with my Roblox?
I have a lot of Roblox in there.
Alright. Alright, this move I just kind of shoehorned in because I know some people like Halo still. I was a big fan of Halo, especially Halo Reach was one of my favorite games. This guy right here actually showed me Halo Reach. What's his name?
Who?
You. You got me into Halo Reach.
Who did?
You.
Yeah, I know.
My friend Twister Phantom here showed me Halo Reach, and I had no idea to play it. You know how, like, these old men have these things called, like, screen blindness when it comes to video games? You know, shit like that? Where you can't really understand what's on the screen?
Yeah.
Some older people have that. Yeah, I couldn't understand what was on the screen at first, and the more and more I played, the more I understood. Like, by my friend here, so I used to go over to his house all the time. Showed him my dick once, but that's a different story.
Yeah. So, I was calling my mom.
No, we're not actually getting to that. Okay, and then, one of the biggest news, new Nintendo Switch game releases. This is a whole list of new games. One of my favorite parts of the Nintendo Direct thing was him, the translator with a straight face saying South Park, the fractured butthole.
The fractured butthole.
I know. It was so funny. Kirby Star Allies is a great game. I suggest everyone get it. Payday 2, they're slowly updating it to where you have the full thing. Shut up, I'm getting to that. Payday 2 is great. I think you should get it. Don't Starve Nintendo Switch Edition. Might be good. I might do a series with that with my friend. Twister Phantom. Dragon Quest Builders, I've not seen anything on that. There's like a leveling system and stuff. It's like Dragon Quest, but Minecraft. Lost Sphere, I know nothing about Lost Sphere. Celeste is, I think a good game. I can't remember. Xenoblade Chronicles. That's been out for a long time. Elder Scrolls. All these are kind of old.
Umamentico. I'll be right back. All right.
What are you doing?
Umamentico. I'll be right back.
Ordering what?
Umamentico. It means one second in Spanish.
I don't know that.
Umamentico.
With people on the camera. Do I look Spanish?
Konnichiwa.
That's Chinese. God damn it. I'll be right back.
I didn't. God damn it. Whatever. All right. So there's just a whole bunch of good games on the Switch. Upcoming games include Smash Brothers, fucking Undertale. No. You're like, yeah, Undertale's gonna be a good game for the Switch. I really think anybody who hasn't played it needs to play it, because it's a good game. Just don't look at the community, because people are toxic. Alright, so, actually, I'm gonna wait for Alejandro to get back for the next news. Also, if anybody doesn't know, if we get some followers in this podcast, I might do a shot of this Hot Ones hot sauce like I did before. It's hot as fuck. What song is it? Also, if anybody wants a job, not a job, anybody wants a song suggestion, anything from Avicii's good, but then also there's this song. The fuck is the name of the song? Man, let me find it on my other side.
Fakufu.
No.
Japanese boy.
There it is. And we're gonna play it. We're gonna play it on stream.
What?
It's called Flamingo.
How many shrimps do you have to eat before your skin turns pink? Eat too many and you'll get sick. Shrimps are really rich.
Shut up! Jesus Christ.
I'm here.
Are you back?
Yeah, I'm here. Just keep yourself entertained while it's coming.
Yeah, I wanted to do like, oh, so my favorite song right now is like Flamingo.
Flamingo. Oh, oh, oh.
Alright, we're moving on to more news. Terraria meets Diablo. This article is from PCGamer.com. Yeah, with 17,000 ads. Terraria meets Diablo and David Vervick's new game, It Lurks Below, now in early access. We're not gonna watch the commercial on not a. Jesus Christ! Shut up, you stupid freaking gecko. Brevik's, I don't know how to say his name. Brevik's new game, Lurks Below, is gonna be a hybrid of like Diablo and it and Terraria, which is gonna be cool because Terraria is kind of like a building game. Oh, you can actually see some screenshots here.
Like Minecraft.
No, it's not like Minecraft. It's never been like Minecraft. People just like saying
it's like Minecraft.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is, and you cannot change my mind about that. I dare.
Play it.
He goes outside of a college saying Terraria is not Minecraft. Change my mind.
Do it. I dare you. I will give someone a TF2 item, a pretty good TF2 item, if they can convince me that TF2
somebody wrote a review saying, there's chickens, 11 out of 10.
Well, I mean, I'll gladly take that offer, because I think that if you do you play Terraria?
Yes, I have played Terraria.
Oh my god, we can all do a Terraria playthrough.
I don't have it, I played it at a friend's house.
Of fucking course you did, you piece of shit. Okay, this podcast is all about being nice to each other and not about my depression.
Depression
is nothing to laugh about either. It actually hurts people, and I might be having some of that.
That's a serious topic.
No, it is a serious topic, to be perfectly honest.
It really is.
Let's move on.
Oh, I'm trying to, but a couple idiots keep going over my voice.
Can I...
Shut up.
Can I do the next one?
Sure.
Is this the EVGAs?
Yep.
All right. So
it's on the screen EVG... if you need it.
Yeah. No. I have it pulled up. All right. So the EVGAs GeForce GTX 1070 Ti Ultra Silent card is now on sale for $510. They're traditionally on sale for a lot more pricey.
Oh, so like let me just tell you this. Like, the best card right now is, like, almost $700?
Yeah,
no, it's,
so
like, around $800.
You just cut off a little chunk of that. So, you got a $510, and they're still in stock. So, this is only 6 hours ago. So, get your GTX 1080s, 1070s.
If it's still on by Friday, I might be getting one.
Yeah, there are only a few different places you can grab this card and discount. The GTA will send it to you directly for $540. It's cheaper on Amazon. It's listed on sale for $510, plus shipping and handling, it's $540 if you get it shipped to your house. It's cheaper on Amazon, especially on Amazon Prime.
Really? Actually, I have Amazon Prime, so that might be helpful.
So you can't ignore this bargain. It's practically back to its original price. Way back when.
Something I wanted to talk about, but I didn't get the news for it. I'm actually going to click on it here. Ninja, a very famous fucking streamer on he's a very famous Fortnite streamer, right? Alright, let me get this fucking out of the way. And I think he's a really nice guy. I think that the way he acts compared to other streamers is much better. Especially like things with Dr. Disrespect and shit. So,
like that one asshole jokes guy, he's like...
Yeah, fuck that guy. Now, to be perfectly honest with you guys, Dr. Disrespect is a great streamer, Ninja's a great streamer, there's a whole bunch of great streamers. It's just, their gimmicks, I don't like what they do, but that's my own opinion. But he just rebroke his own record from when he was streaming with, Drake. Which is funny, because he literally just did the freaking thing. not even like 2 weeks ago, and it's his own record. UFO shapes have appeared in Fortnite. Signs say a comet could hit tomorrow.
Oh my god, Tilted Towers is going to be destroyed. But I love Tilted Towers. It's just like the twin. Okay, I'm not going to make that joke.
Alejandro, are you still here?
I'm not.
Alejandro, blink twice if you're alive. This.
Wiggle your toes 69 times.
Wiggle the tip of your dick if you're still alive.
Just the tip.
Just the tip. So basically what I want to talk about is Ninja is a really good streamer. I think, you know, he's really good. He used to be a professional gamer. I think he was a professional gamer for about 8 to 7 years. That information's from the H3H3 podcast. So suggest you guys go listen to that too. And he's been at it. I mean, he just hosted NinjaCon or whatever that is. Ninja Vegas, I think it's called. And it was one of the biggest events hosted by a Twitch representative, basically. He did a lot. He had a lot of people there. I believe Myth was there. He's a big Fortnite streamer too. And Myth is a real professional player. And he bought, like, there was companies sending out people to try to beat Ninja. And what was funny is that Myth killed himself twice.
Hello. Sorry. Apologize. I had a pizza in the oven.
No, it's fine. We're talking about Ninja. And I was talking about how Myth was another Fortnite streamer. He just, basically showed up to Ninja's tournament that he held in Vegas.
Yeah.
And he was, you know, he's a professional player. A whole bunch of professional people, because I know Ninja is such a big streamer, sent people to the event.
Damn.
And they were like, let's try to outdo Ninja and try to get some viewers. Myth failed so hard.
Really?
Like, he did a 1-by-1 tower at one point, and he fell off of it.
Oof.
Instantly killing himself. And then the other time, he was like, listen, I'm gonna go in there, I'm gonna kill him, I'm just gonna be done with all this, I'm gonna win this. And he dies automatically, so,
Oof.
Oof. So yeah, Ninja's doing good for himself. I'm glad that he breaks his own freaking record again. That's great. More viewers to Twitch means more money for me. More friends for my stream. Not more money.
Money is
not the answer. Let me just pull away all these things about money on my screen real quick. Just kind of.
God, I want to play MVM.
Oh my god, what is with you in Team Fortress 2?
It's a good game, mate.
It is a good game. Okay, next in the news. How long has this been going for?
God knows.
I usually have a time up.
Nah, mate.
Really? I don't have a time?
Sir, I can smell the weed on you. You are going to jail for life.
Detective Bird has redeemed a question. Fuck you.
Oh, I've smelt it. Don't.
Yeah, how long have we been going?
It
usually tells me how long I've been open. But it isn't. I don't know. Why did we remove that? Ew. Whatever. I don't know how long we've been going, but we're still going. Okay, next up in the news, Microsoft blocks Halo Online mod. Basically, it's like an old... It's like Halo, but the original game. Shooter and stuff for the PC. And it's really good, but the problem is... problem is that they're going after the online thing just so... the team's basically saying, we don't want people doing this because we might be doing something like this in the future. Problem is that they probably just want to be like, listen, we know that this is what you guys want.
I know,
but
right?
This is too much free for us, so we're gonna take it down.
Because we're not getting enough money.
Yeah, we're not getting enough money from this.
We need money.
Actually, funny fact about this game, it's only been out for about 3 weeks, and the population in Halo 6 has gone down about 30%.
That's probably why, they don't want people wasting. But that,
the thing is that their servers crashed on the first day it released. They said it can only hold 10,000 people. They had to increase it double.
Dude, I'm gonna play that Ace as soon as possible after this. Not like today. I might do some Team Fortress after this, but whatever. Yeah, so that's in the news. Microsoft just basically saying, hey, we're gonna block this, you know, because it's our IP, can't really do this, you know, basic corporate stuff, basically what they're saying.
I think I hate my life.
Is it because you gained weight? What does it say? Oh yeah, Blizzard accidentally revealed Overwatch's Horizon Lunar Colony map. It's getting a major rework. It's definitely getting a rework, thank God, because the original was a... I don't know. This is from PCGamer.com. We're not watching the video. It is one of the Overwatch's most hated maps of all time. I can agree to that too. Because all you need is a Bastion or something just sitting down. And Bastion sitting down with a turret with multiple shields and your god on that point. So you don't really need, like, anything. You just sit there and just everything. Like, there's no point to playing it. So they're redoing it, thank God. I can't wait to see what's coming from that.
Yeah, what's coming from it is, I believe, new spawn points, there's new advantage points. They're adding new, like, I think, areas to the map so that you can get around easier. So it's not just that main hallway.
Which is definitely needed, I think, in
my opinion. Yeah, because this map could be really good, potentially. Like, really good, but...
Yeah, like the low gravity in sections, that's an awesome mechanic. But you need to implement it very well with a... And when you have that type of mechanic on a bad map, it's not helping anyone. It's hurting people.
I feel like it could definitely be like an airlock thing where, like, for 30 seconds of the map, the whole map is just anti-gravity or something.
That would
like
be kind of cool.
Yeah, that'd be really cool and competitive to see, like, what people come up with.
How they react to it? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. If they're, you know, they're floating in midair, like, with tracers.
Imagine if, like, you're locked down as a Bastion, and as soon as, like, the thing starts, like, to levitate everyone, you're just a Bastion. You start to raise up over barricade. That would be so cool to see.
Yeah, that would be, honestly.
Yeah, so Horizon Lunar Colony getting an update, which is good, in my opinion.
And other Overwatch news.
Yeah, and other Overwatch news, which is one of our last articles, our last article. Overwatch has many different PTR changes right now. One of them being, Hanzo's different abilities, Stormbow. Why is it called Stormbow now? Projectile speed increased to 85 to 100. Sonic arrow decreased from 20 seconds to 12 seconds. Duration decreased from 10 seconds to 6 seconds. Why is that such a dramatic change?
Well, if you think about it, the scatter shot itself is being removed from the game and it's being replaced by a burst shot.
Yeah, but like this, destroying scatter arrow is not needed. It's pretty good, and you don't need to decrease it, because now it's going to be like, you see somebody for like 5 seconds and then you're done.
I think what they're trying to do is they're trying to promote, like, fair gameplay with Hanzo instead of using the scatter shot.
Wait, so now he also has a double jump?
I believe he's always had a double jump.
No, he hasn't. He's had a jump, and then he could jump up walls.
You're right. He has a double jump.
Now he has a double jump.
Okay.
Storm arrows replace existing scatter arrow ability. Hanzo can now rapidly fire up to 6 arrows that deal reduced damage but are fired at full power. New options and maintain high damage output. Cool. Frag launcher projectile size decreases from 0.3 to 0.2. Wow. Okay. That's just means it's gonna be a little bit harder to hit people. I'm pretty good aiming with the junk. I'm pretty good with Junkrat, so I don't think that's gonna really affect people who has really good aim. It just means maybe that there's gonna be a higher skill cap for Junkrat and stuff. Wait, why? This. Fuck that. I'm not going through that shit. Tire movement is now decreased from 13 to 12. That also means that you're gonna have to, like, maybe get a little bit closer, maybe just try to figure out where you need to put your tire in the right place a little bit quicker, because sometimes you just need to do that. A lot of changes to Lucio's wall ride. Basically all it's saying is that it will be smoother to go around corners, it'll be smoother to ride, that if you go over a little thing, it won't bump you off, it'll actually keep you on the wall. Another thing is that it will, when you jump off, you don't jump off as fast, about 0.5 difference now. Also, if you jump off the wall, you can now go back onto the same wall, which is good, comparatively to what we had before. Before, you had to jump off and you couldn't jump back on the wall, same wall, you would just fall. But now you can actually keep in the same wall, so that gives a high possibility to Lucio kind of disrupt, you know, get on the point and just being like, no, you can't capture this point because I'm on it. Which is something I would like to really see, because Lucio is very good at booping people off the point and also just keeping the point alive for this team. Wow, I'm talking a lot.
I mean, also, isn't even the slow generation of his healing and also speed boosts just, you know, just conveniently, you know, you will always regenerate while you're with Lucio, which is wonderful.
Also, the sound wave no longer consumes ammo. Wait, what is sound wave? Is that his ult?
I think that is his boop.
Oh, so now his boop doesn't consume ammo?
Doesn't seem so. The only thing I can think of for Soundwave is probably his back.
All right, Tracer Pulse Bomb. Max damage decreased from 400 to 300. I mean, I don't know why you would do this. I literally have no idea why you would reduce the Pulse Bomb.
I think I know why.
Why?
So, if I remember correctly, Orisa's health is 400, and so basically Tracer can get behind Orisa, stick her, and she's dead.
I guess, if they're focusing on Orisa. But then, think about all the other tanks and stuff, then you would have to go through.
I believe Winston has 500 health as well, so that does a lot to Winston.
Genji deflects, hitbox has been decreased, so that's great. Sure. Hitbox has been decreased. That means just that you're not gonna get as many projectiles when they're all being launched at you. Shield bash cone angle has been reduced from 90 to 60. That has been something I've been complaining about, is that when she shield bashes you, it felt like she could hit you from anywhere. Cause like, when she shield bashes you, she stuns you. When she hits you with your flare, she stuns you. When she hits you, she gains health. Like, there's nothing you could fucking do. There's nothing.
I've never particularly encountered a Bridget as I played Overwatch this past week, so I wouldn't know. I've never seen Bridget actually played before, ever.
Really?
Yeah, I'm being serious. I never looked on up any PC? Gameplay on her. Yeah, on PC.
Dude, we need to do some PC mashups.
Oh, damn.
Okay.
I mean, we could do the Retribution update while it's still out.
I mean, we could. Probably would look shit on this computer because I can't really stream well. you know?
It's okay.
I might do some. Alright, so I think that's really it for news so far for today. So, should we just close this out and I'll start doing some gaming content a little bit later?
I mean, whatever's up to you, man. It's your stream.
All right. Well, I like keeping these a little bit shorter just because I'm also going to be editing these after. So, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for watching. My name has been Jelxies, and this has been Twister Phantom and Lieutenant Bird. If you guys want to talk to me about this and maybe suggest some questions, you can go to my Discord, the Ethan Jared Productions Discord, originally created for a game. But that is no longer.
You can submit them. I have a question.
Yep.
A question. When's Five Nights at Luigi's?
Listen. I hate you so much. That's one of our most suggested videos. Dude, and I've been getting views on, like, how to make Five Nights at Freddy's full screen recently. People have been watching it, and I've been getting, like, it's one of my most grossing videos right now.
Really?
Yeah, and guys, like, could you make this for Russian?
What?
And I'm like, and I'm like, why are you guys still playing Five Nights at Freddy's in 2018?
Oh, did you hear that Russia actually, they have Steam now in Russia, so that's why.
Oh, really?
No, I'm kidding, I'm totally bullshitting.
I'm like, what? No! I'm like, they have Steam.
Oh, fun fact about Steam.
fun fact about Steam.
There is one confirmed account from North Korea on Steam, and we believe it's Kim Jong-un. Kim Jong-un is the only one that has a Steam. There is one confirmed location from
Korea. If anybody kills him in Overwatch, he's nuking America. Somebody said no balls to him, and he did it.
Actually, he plays on the Asian server, so we're fine.
Oh, what are you talking about? Him, as long as if he plays on Korean servers, he's gonna fucking die to all the South Koreans.
It's not my problem.
Yeah, when you get fucking nuked, it will be your goddamn problem. Alright, thank you guys for watching. This has been my compadres. You can find Alejandro's YouTube, I think, somewhere online. Twister Phantom.
Yeah, you just type in red_Nico and it comes up.
Wait, I did.
I'm pretty sure I did. I don't particularly know. I don't really look on my YouTube. I just post, like, videos that I edit and direct in my film
channel. If I do post this soon on to YouTube, yeah, thank you guys for watching. Remember to hit the like button and subscribe if you can. If you guys are watching this through Twitch VODs, remember to hit follow and come back for more. You guys can find all my information down below or, through my Twitter/ Jelks_. And yeah, Detective Bird and Red Nico, you've been great.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for joining me on this podcast. Remember to come back next time to level with us some more. Bye-bye.